did you get into bodybuilding?
So I got into the fitness industry because I was in the military for a long time. And one of the requirements was to be physically active enough to pass a PT test. So you had to do push-ups, sit-ups, and a run. And after I got home from all of my training and I was working full-time for the National Guard, I had the opportunity of 2 hours a day to go to the gym and train. And so I signed up for my first gym membership at Gold's Gym in Ogden, Utah. 2014, I tried, you know, prepping for my first show for NPC and bodybuilding. And at the time, there was only the bodybuilding and physique for men's. And about 8 weeks out from that first show, I got whooping cough, which was crazy because adults don't normally get that. And it put me down for a while. And I think it was sick for about 6 months for recovery. And so I tried again in 2015. With the same coach, and again, you know, 6 to 8 weeks out, I got pneumonia. So I was like, all right, well, it's just kind of like, I'm not gonna do this, it's too hard on my body. That's kind of when I'm like, all right, well, I go to the gym all the time, and I've tried to do these shows before, but I, you know, I don't really know what I wanna do. But again, that desire's always been there to compete in bodybuilding, like bring my best package. I wanna become my best self. So I went on this journey for self-growth and, just trying to better myself. I came up with this this idea of, in order for me to be the best parent for my children, I need to be the best version of myself. And so in order to do that, it's a mental game, it's a spiritual game, it's a physical game, you know, so everything kind of ties together. And in the summer of last year, I had a mental breakdown and I hit depression so hard with everything. I was getting ready to lose my house. You know, my job, I couldn't support my kids, my car broke down, just like everything kind of just came in on me. And I had a night where, you know, I almost didn't survive it. If it wasn't for somebody that I look up into the fitness industry that reached out to me, you know, that night, I wouldn't be where I am today. Called me, told him the whole situation, like I'm losing everything. You know, I'm collapsing, I can't do this anymore. And that was a turning point for me. I went to sleep that night, woke up the next morning, and I felt, you know, pretty bad about everything. I still felt like I wasn't worth anything. You know, relationships weren't working, dating wasn't helping me out, you know. I realized that I don't need anybody in my life to support me. This is something that I want to do. I have to do it for myself, by myself. And it's just crazy the amount of support I've gotten from my close friends that I deem worthy to call family, right? And there's a lot of people in this industry that are supporting me that I never had their support before, where, you know, people are checking in on me, how are things going? Let's go to the gym together, let's go train, let's do cardio parties together, things like that. So it's just all things that are kind of helping me stay on track. And then a lot of opportunities that have come up recently, so I feel like this is my time.
Oh, not a fan. Not a fan of the snow in my face.
Let's see how good Utah drivers are today. Probably not very good. I mean, I'm doing this to show my kids that if you have a goal, you should attempt to achieve it. Since, you know, competing in bodybuilding has always been a thing of mine, you know, like an idea in the back of my head, I'm like, why not go for it? I mean, I've had a lot of things come up over the years that have prevented me from being able to do it, but there's nothing holding me back right now, so I'm doing it for them, just to show them, like, hey, doesn't matter how big your dreams are, or how far out of reach they might be, like, consistently work towards them, and you can achieve that. So that's the first thing I think about them is, like, the, you know, I guess the example I'm trying to be for them. I'm just really tired. I just want to sleep all day. I'm pretty excited about just being here because it's been something I've worked towards for 4 years. I started the whole idea of competition prep back in 2014 and I failed those first two times and I actually made it. I mean, a few days ago, I was at the gym. I was training in Ogden for the last time before I flew out to Nebraska, and just had like this sense of like, the first time in my life, I was proud of myself. Like I've fulfilling a goal and a dream of mine that I wanted to achieve for a long period of time. And so, more or less, like I'm not nervous as far as like having a routine or posing or anything like that. I I'm taking this as a learning experience, right? I want to go through all the motions and know what to do, what to expect. I've had a lot of people reach out to me that haven't said a word to me like this entire prep, like they doubted me for sure. And it was funny because my roommate, he told me yesterday, he's like, you actually look like a fitness competitor for the first time in your life, and now people are starting to take you serious because you're actually going through with this. So it's kind of like a humbling experience, just like hear that from him, because he's competed and he's nationally qualified. Just to have the amount of like support from people that I don't talk to on a regular basis, whether it's through social media or people at the gym, recently has really just made me feel like I'm doing the right thing. And in reflection of like looking back on the past 4 months, people ask me, you know, well, what was the hardest part? Well, for me, it was more of a mental challenge, right? Can I do this? Am I capable of doing this? Can I stick to the plan? Can I stay up late and get cardio done? Can I get all the stretching done? Can I get the massage work done when I need to? And the ab work every day and the workouts, and you know, because there were a lot of days where I was training by myself. You know, it was just a lot of struggles that way, where it's like a lot of nights at home, you know, with my kids. When my kids go to sleep, it's like, okay, now I can do cardio, now I can do meal prep. And I just had a lot of nights by myself. And so when you know, you have that much downtime and you're just going through your head, you know, man, I kind of wish I had somebody here to help me or to support me or whatever it is. And I had to realize during the process that, you know, this is something that I had to do for myself. So, I mean, I'm feeling really good. Like I said, I'm not nervous. I'm more excited. But more or less, like, I'm mentally, like, I've already made it, you know? I'm already in the best shape of my life that I've ever been in. And my mind has changed a lot. My mindset has changed a lot. I've surrounded myself with better quality people. My desires of how I want to spend my free time has changed a lot. I've learned to enjoy my own company. I have no problem sitting at home, you know, with a book or a game or show anymore, or just even in silence. This has been kind of a healing process for me overall, with, you know, dealing with depression pretty bad last year and overcoming those struggles. I think I'm finally coming to terms with myself and realizing that I've allowed myself to heal my wounds from the past by spending so much time alone, working towards a goal by myself and showing, you know, myself and everybody else that I can do it.
Number 62, Jesse Howell.
Today's gonna be the day that they're gonna throw it back to you. By now, you should have somehow realized what you gotta do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. Backbeat, the wood is on the street, that the fire in your heart is out. I'm sure you heard it all before, but you never really had a doubt. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now.
You're a runner-up in second place, number 62, Jesse Howell.
And all the lies that lead us there.
Blood. Let's give that fourth place trophy to number 62, Jesse Howell.
There are many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how.
This is your first show. How do you feel?
I feel really good. I want to do it again already, but I have a lot to learn. I got to get posing down. I need to do more conditioning. I need bigger size on my upper body, but my legs are really good, so. Feeling really good. I'm happy. I achieved a goal that I've had for a very long time. You know, I got two trophies today, second place and fourth place. It's pretty cool, you know, that I actually placed my very first show. A lot of people didn't do that. Overall, I think it's a win. This is just the beginning. I got a lot of things I can accomplish in the next couple years. You know, I just turned 30, so I mean, I can definitely do something in a fitness career for the next 10 years, so, you know.
It is what it is. We'll see how it goes. I'm excited. I'm very excited.